Anzac Day was marked up and down the country and in the Pacific as well.
That's right, and yesterday two of our communities with a strong association with the First World War had special reason to celebrate. John Utanga has more.
161119.
A roll call of New Wayne heroes.
161120.
Part of a tradition from the island started by the Mutilau community here in Auckland.
Going back to the history of Niue, the village of Mutilau was the first village on Niue to have erected a cenotaph in 1947. So we wanted to continue the history over here and the legacy, since we have the population here, majority of them are residing in New Zealand.
Now it's a way for all Niueans to come together and remember.
I'm incredibly impressed, happy to see a lot of young people.
Niueans have a special affinity with the Anzacs, and especially World War I. That's when 150 of their young were recruited to serve with New Zealand forces overseas.
I'm incredibly proud that Niue has contributed to that. 150 strong, they were our best, they were our people that had strong hearts, but also very loyal at the time to Queen Victoria, whom they have given their allegiance to.
For many, that allegiance and remembrance is what Anzac Day is about.
Anzac Day commemorations normally start with the dawn parade like this, and they take place in small towns and cities all over New Zealand. This year's celebrations take on a special significance. It's the 100-year anniversary of the start of World War I.
Among those in attendance at this dawn ceremony, representatives from the Cook Islands community.
In World War I, there were over 500 of our Cook Islanders that were conscripted by Sir Maui Pōmari into the First World War, and many of them came here to New Zealand, trained, and then went over into the Western Front and were significant in the tunnelling and the mining, but also fought during their conflict.
I'm so glad I came here. For me, it's really humbling. And today at the R2 Hostel, we will be celebrating with commemorating with all the Cook Islanders in Akarana.
The encouraging presence of young people at recent ceremonies was not lost on the organisers of this year's Niue commemorations, who invited theatre company Killer Coconut Crew to perform, a gesture welcomed by its Niue cast members.
It makes it even much more humbling to know that my fellow uncles, grandpas, cousins, families, wherever they stood as family, they died for our freedom, and they fought for our freedom.
And community leaders hope that humility translates into support in the years to come.
The challenge to our people now is that it needs to continue so that when they move on, these other generations coming up can do the same. But it needs to be remembered in such a way that it becomes meaningful in the lives of our people.